So guys, in this video we'll be seeing about the SQL injection and mostly error based SQL injections. So I'll be explaining the basics of SQL injection and then we will see error based injection. So in the next video we will see the union based SQL injections, and we will be doing these two steps in this video. So you can see, first I will explain the basics of the SQL injection. I have this table info, and it contains three columns: ID, username, and the password. And ID 1, arrow, and his password: flash, flash, Superman, Superman. So these are the contents of the table. Okay. So in the application backend, so like PHP or Python, so the query will be like this: select ID, comma username, comma password from info, where ID is equals to 2, so semicolon. So you will get the result, right? So whenever let's say username from info, where ID is equals to 2, so here we are getting the username, right? So in the application backend, what it have is, it will have the like dollar username or something input you need to provide in the URL. So it should be like this, like $a. So whatever you send the data in the URL, it will be placed instead of a. Okay. So instead of providing 2, so there will be already one quotation mark. So what you can do is, you can provide like this 2 single quote, and then what you can do is, you can do the true statement, so like this. So what this means is, first we are making sure that ID is 2, and then we are using the OR and checking the 1 is equal to 1. So whenever this query has been executed, I will get the same result as this one. So let me execute this one, and you can see we got the username. Why did we get the more than flash? Because this is becoming true, so that's why the username column has been entirely displayed. So you can see, if this input is not filtered correctly, you can get much more information. So you can also do end injection, so you will get only the flash, because we are doing the end operation. So both of these cases should be true. When I do OR operation, it will be this one. And if I say 1 is equals to 2, this is false, true or false, and then you will get this only flash. So how this reach to, you can see now this reach to data leakage. And also if you have like select username comma password, or like select ID from info, where username is equals to flash and password is equals to flash. So now you can see ID is 2. So now what I can do? So instead of flash, I don't know the password. Let's assume flash 213, and then here in the input field, what I can do is, I can write some flash and single quote, and then I can put the comment. So this will be ignored, and if I hit enter, put the semicolon, and I get the 2, even though my password is the wrong, but this has been commented by this our comment. So in the SQL you can see two hyphens are the comment, and also this pound symbol is also the comment. Okay, so these two are the comments in the SQL, and you can see from this input I have put the single quote and then put the comment. So this part has been truncated, and of course we got the result. So you can bypass the authentication if you know the username. So you can also brute force these usernames. So you can see from now, if you did not filter this input, it gives so many problems. So now let's go and do the lab. So here they are saying vulnerability in category filter. So there is this is the backend query. So what you can do is we can put this single quote and test this. So let's access the lab. So here what the query is doing is it is only displaying the released products. So let's say accessories. So here you can see categories is equals to accessories. So what I can do is I can put the single quote and hit enter. Now you can see internal server, that means the entire query string has been error because of this single quote. So that's why it throws an error. So here what you can do is you need to specify or true statement. So here you will get the true, the entire condition will be true and you will be displayed every item. So you can see you get much more information. So you can see congratulations, you have solved the lab. So here what you can do is let's see URL encoded. So here first check the URL with the single or double quote and see if there is an error. So okay, it says congratulations, you have solved. Okay, if you get some SQL errors like internal server error in this case, but actually you can see the error on this web page. So in that case you can do the R and end to see you get much more information like a data leakage. Okay, so that is about the first step. So next step is about the login bypass using this same. So access the lab. Okay, here you can see the URL and let's click on my account. And now let's say temp and hit enter. So the parameters are being sent as a body. So let's copy this and paste here. So I have already my burp on. So let's intercept on and let's say temp login. I'll send this to repeater. So here you can see the data's credentials are being sent in a body. So here I can test the parameters, username, put the single quote. So you can see there is an internal server error. That means this parameter can be prone to SQL injection. Let's make it true statement or 1 is equals to 1 and then we are truncating the password field. So I think you need to So we need to URL encode. So we can also use this functionality in the burp. So you click on this URL encode as you type. So upon typing, it will automatically encode into URL. So let's click on send. And 302 phone. So here we are redirecting to the account login. Okay. So that means I can just go ahead and say, and you can also put this one, copy paste here, invalid CSRF token. So okay, let's go ahead and do this in one, because the CSRF token mismatch. You can also paste this in the password if you think the username has a separate query and password has a separate query, and click on login. Now you can see we are the administrator. Okay, so let's close this. So we have done the two dApps where we use this error based SQL injection. Now let's go and do it in Python. So let's see whether we can automate this entire process. First one is R, one is equals to one. The next one is so let me try these two R payloads. So I have already writing this script, and I also done for the union based injection. So we'll be seeing in the next videos. So okay, so let's so let's define a function. So let's click on lifestyle, copy this and paste here. So R is equals to request. First let's get the page. URL. So that function we need to pass this URL. So we need to try every payload. So let's go in and do that for I in R payloads R range of. So this gives some more flexibility. URL plus. So we need to append this R payloads. R payloads of I. So each time we iterate through this list, so we'll be appending at the last of the URL and we are getting. So if dot r dot status code. So this will tell whether the we have successful response or not. Let's say 200. If after getting this injection, if we got the 200, then let's say print. So we are telling that we are outputting that this payload has been worked. or we can say URL plus payload. You can also put the hash here. So let's, I think that's it for this R payload. So let's go ahead and run this. So you can see both of these have been worked successfully. So like this you can automate using the Python.